Here, we will explain how to plan production schedules with equipment capacity constraints. Asprova does not use fixed lead times, but calculates production lead times by the constraints of equipment capacity, so we can reply with the exact due date. We enter sales orders of electrical cables to the order table. We enter the items, quantities, and due dates for each order. The current inventory quantities, at the time of scheduling, are entered as inventory orders. These items are set to safety stock levels, and these are produced in predetermined lot sizes. Next, let's check the resource Gantt chart. The vertical axis displays machines and resources, and the horizontal axis displays time. Based on calendar settings, the gray areas are the working hours in which operations can be assigned. Other areas are non-working time periods, and no operations can be assigned there. The left side of the assignment start time is the past period, and the right side is the future period. Stock on hand and privileged operations are assigned to the past period, while schedules are assigned to the future period. When we click the Reschedule button, a schedule is created. When we search for order 1017, connection lines appear. These lines graphically represent the allotment of inventory and produced items. They are referred to as pegs in Asprova. Let's check the order Gantt chart. In this manufacturing order, stranded copper wire is pegged to purchase, and coating material is pegged to inventory and purchase. Three types of coated wires are produced on June 8th and 9th, and they are laid up on June 14th. The multi-core cable is sheathed on June 15th, and the finished item is produced on June 17th. Let's check the schedule in more detail. We check the details of manufacturing order M000040. 12,000 meters of coated wire is produced with insulation 1. The production time is 5 hours, from 12 p.m. to 5 p.m. According to the integrated master, the capacity is 40 meters per minute. Therefore, the production time for 12,000 meters is 12,000 meters divided by 40 meters, which equals 300 minutes or 5 hours. The production time is calculated automatically based on the production quantity and the production capacity of the integrated master. Items in inventory are automatically pegged. When we click the use instruction bar of the inventory, connection lines are displayed on pegged operations. We can display the inventory graph of the coating material to check the changes in the inventory. The safety stock quantity is indicated with a red line. We see that the inventory does not fall below this red line, or in other words, the safety stock. One way of checking whether there are any late orders is to use the filter function on the PEG order Gantt chart. Let's display only late orders to check if there are any. Since nothing is displayed, we know that there are no late orders. Finally, let's check the dispatching view for the work instructions. The dispatching view shows operations in the order they are dispatched for each machine and worker. Or, we can apply filters to display certain properties on the operation table and use it as an instruction list. Please take advantage of this feature, such as by exporting the data to an instruction tool.